Hey guys, welcome back to the Martin Family Channel. I am filming a super fun video today. I have been so excited about this video since I came up with the idea. It is a get ready with me Q&A, and I had you guys ask me literally so many questions. So I'm gonna go through every single question, make sure that I answer them all. And I'm just super excited and so glad that you guys had so many questions to ask me. So let me know down in the comments anything that you find out about me that you didn't know already, because that always intrigues me. And let me know something about you that I probably don't know down in the comments. Make sure that you give this video a like, a comment, and let's get ready. Okay, first question. Who are your favorite YouTubers? My favorite YouTuber right now is definitely Kristen Johns. If you don't watch her, you need to go watch her now. She is my dream. Like, I wish I could have her house, her closet, her makeup, everything. I just use this Carmex. I talked about it in my current favorites video, so make sure that you watch that next. But, okay, next question. What is something you wish you could tell your younger self? This is a great question. It's kind of like preached on in this world now that, like, if you don't have sex, then you're not cool. But I wish that I would have saved myself till marriage. And then also, if I could tell myself something else, whenever I was younger, I would definitely tell myself to put back 10% of every single paycheck that I make, like every single paycheck from the time that I start making money. And any time that someone gives me money, if I would have gotten $10 and would have put $1 in savings, I would have had literally so much savings. The next question is favorite videos to make. And honestly, I feel like that is such a hard question because I really love sit down videos where I just get to talk to you guys. Like, I've been so excited to film this video for you guys because I knew that I would just get to kind of sit and talk. And if you know me in real life, like if you've ever met me, you know that I have a major talking issue and I could talk to anyone for 10 centuries. So I really love sit down videos truly, but and I love to edit them because they're much easier to edit, but there's something so satisfying about editing like a clean and decorate with me or like a morning routine video, because it comes together so well at the end and you just feel so accomplished whenever you finish editing that whole entire video. Do I like being a mom? I love being a mom. It's the greatest thing in the entire world. Like, I felt like I wanted to be a mom since I was a little kid, so it's awesome. But if you don't want to be a mom, then good for you for knowing that too. I give props to any woman that wants to be a mom or doesn't want to be a mom. Like, that is just something, both sides, is that is something so like just powerful to me. Go to road trip snack. If I'm trying to be super, this is called Model's Own, I think. I got it forever ago, and I just like the colors that are in this palette. I don't hardly ever do my mascara or my eyeshadow, but doing it today. My go-to road trip snack. If I'm feeling kind of healthy, I like to eat some trail mix, which you know I love trail mix, but I like to eat some trail mix with a Body Armor. Strawberry banana is my favorite flavor. And then some beef jerky. Or if I'm having like a sweet tooth and I'm like, you know, this is gonna be a long road trip, I need something sweet, I like to eat chocolate covered Flips pretzels with a Diet Coke, fountain Diet Coke. Bottled Diet Coke is a no-go. Next question is, how many kids do you want? You know, I would love to have 4 children, but that's a lot of money and it's expensive. So 4 children will come if Tyler and I are at a place financially where it's realistic and it makes sense. But if I only had 2 kids or 3 kids, I am content. Like, I'm content with how many of our children God gives me. I really want more than one because I loved having siblings, but if I can't have another baby, then that's just something that I would have to cross whenever I got to it, and I probably would not like be terribly upset because I know how hard it is to just have one, and I know that I am so lucky to be the mother to Karsten after having one miscarriage. Like, that's one thing that my miscarriage taught me, is just like, it is so, so special that I have one child. When do you want to try for your second? I don't want to try for my second baby until at least after my 21st birthday, but I would love to wait until Karsten is either potty training or completely out of diapers. Do you have a job besides YouTube and being a mommy? Yes, actually, I do. I work at the dry bar and I haven't worked since before the pandemic. I normally work doing hair. I'm a cosmetologist, I'm a licensed cosmetologist, and I love working at the dry bar. I love my boss. It's good money and it's so fun, and the clients are so sweet. If you've never heard of the dry bar or you've never been to a dry bar, look it up. It is the greatest thing ever. All I do is style hair. I don't color or cut it or anything like that. It's so fun. Next question is, what's your guilty pleasure? If you feel like I'm flying through these questions, it's because I'm kind of trying to keep my answers to just like straight into the point, because I got so many questions. I was so shocked by how many questions I got. But my guilty pleasure is honestly a clean home and having no notifications on my phone. That sounds so silly, but that is genuinely my guilty pleasure. Like, nothing bothers me more than having a ton of social media notifications, and nothing bothers me more than a dirty home. Like, my husband can attest 1,000 times over, I hate a dirty home. I'm so curious, how tall are you? I am 5'2". So I'm not super tall at all, but I actually really like my height. I have never felt like I want to be taller. I really like being how tall I am. And yeah, that's that. Are you working right now? I already answered that. No, I'm just trying to get monetized on YouTube so I can kind of have like a side gig income with that. And I would love to just keep on growing this platform. So make sure that you like and subscribe. What's your favorite childhood memory? Whenever I was looking through these the other day, I was kind of thinking, like, what is one of my favorite childhood memories that I can like genuinely remember? And then I saw someone post on Instagram of them and their cousins like going camping. And that is honestly probably one of my favorite memories as a little kid. It's just going camping with my cousins, because we always had so much fun. My parents always had a tent, and my grandparents had a camper, and we just went camping all the time, almost every weekend. And I remember fires and s'mores and swimming and just everything fun about going to the campground. Not a question, but do you have any advice for losing friends after teen/young pregnancy? Honestly, screw them. That's that. I feel like your family is so big. Have a job, have a passion, have a hobby. And if that's what you have, then you have everything, because you have your kid. And that's that. Anyone that doesn't want to be involved in your life after having a child, they literally just don't deserve a place in your life. Like, period, end of story. If they can't understand that you have a child, then they don't deserve to be in your life. That's that. I went through this, and it sounds kind of harsh and like I'm just like still bitter about it, and I'm not. I'm just firm in my ground. If you cannot respect the fact that I have a kid and I'm gonna put that kid first every single day, then why are we friends? So that's my answer. What are three things on your bucket list? My number one thing on my bucket list is to go on a vacation, just me and Tyler, somewhere that is tropical, like Bora Bora or Hawaii or something fun and beautiful like that, because I think that Tyler and I would have so much fun, and I feel like we deserve it. And yeah, I would love to do that. Another one of my bucket list wishes would be to go on a cruise. A lot of my bucket list wishes are kind of like vacation related. I'd love to go on a Disney cruise with my kids whenever they are all older, because I think that that would be so fun, and I think that they would love that. I've never been on a cruise myself, and I had never been to Disney. I don't think that I could remember, at least until I met Tyler and his family. So I would love to just take my kids on a Disney cruise whenever they're a little bit older and they can just understand the magic and just the happiness of it. And then my third bucket list wish would be to just keep on growing this platform on YouTube and just keep on getting all the support that I have right now, and just keep growing and get monetized and become an influencer that actually kind of like has a name other than just like I'm a small YouTuber. You know, I would love to grow my platform to where it's much bigger than what it is now. How did you know Tyler was the one? It sounds cliche and it sounds silly, but you literally just know. Like, Tyler and I literally never stopped hanging out whenever we met. It was like we just clicked and our families clicked, and I never wanted to leave him alone. We were able to still have friends, like leave him alone. That's not what I meant. I meant like I never wanted to do anything without him, but we still had time and space apart from each other, and that's something that I had never had with a significant other before. All my other significant others were very like, they wanted to be with me 24/7. I couldn't have other friends, that kind of thing. And Tyler and I's friends meshed, and we had the same values, the same morals, the same wants in life. And so we got married 8 months after we met. Why did you start your YouTube channel? I've always wanted to start a YouTube channel. I actually tried to start one whenever I was a senior in high school, and I couldn't figure out how to upload. So that was embarrassing. But so I tried to start a YouTube channel in high school because I just thought it would be so fun to document my life. And I've always felt like I have so much good advice and just like a fun life. Like, I know that sounds so cocky, but I'm not meaning for it to. It's just like, I've always felt like I have a life worth sharing because I have a positive attitude. I have faith in God and I love my family and I love my friends and just that kind of thing. And I have a lot of, my life has been kind of crazy and just like bittersweet at the same time. And so I just feel like I have a life worth sharing. And I love just getting to meet all these people through an online platform because I don't really love to hang out with people in person unless they're my family or they're friends that I already have. And I also, whenever we started it with Tyler, I also really wanted to, sorry, I didn't show you. Everything that I just did was with that same exact palette, but this is just an e.l.f. Light medium powder. I don't like to wear like full face makeup. Like foundation and that kind of thing. But whenever Tyler and I started our YouTube channel, he had actually always wanted to start one too with his future wife. And so that's kind of why we started it, because we wanted to just document everything about our lives together so we had something for our kids to look back on. And it will just be so cool to just like sit down and have a night where we're like, let's binge our YouTube videos. So that's kind of why I wanted to start a YouTube channel. And having the support of my husband was huge too. Like, him wanting to be involved in it is so, so sweet and so awesome. What's your favorite Karsten milestone? My favorite Karsten milestone would probably have to be like whenever he started feeding himself food, because one, it's so cute to like see his little hands and his eyes work and connect and all of that. But it's also so cute just to like him try different foods and him love different foods and that kind of thing. And I also love the freedom that it gives me to be able to clean the kitchen while he eats lunch, or mop the floors while he eats lunch, whatever it is that I'm doing for that day, or do my makeup really quick or whatever it is. I love that about it. If you could be doing anything right now, what would you want to do? If I could be doing anything right now, I would be a big time influencer. If you could pick what superpower you had, what would you want? If I had a superpower, I would want to be able to either freeze time or make it to where I was super, super fast at getting everything done, because I feel like I have a never ending to-do list and I always want to complete my to-do list. And if I don't complete my to-do list, I can't sleep at night because, well, that's just who I am. Please make a video of baby must-haves. I'm always on the hunt for new useful baby things. If you watch my YouTube videos, you know that I include a lot of like baby must-haves throughout videos. And if you don't already follow me on Instagram, make sure that you do. I feel like I don't really have a ton of baby must-haves, but I have a few. I'm very minimal and I don't need a ton of things. I just kind of make life work, because what if we didn't have everything that we already have? Like, what if one day, like, the whole universe just shut down and I had nothing and I had to fend for myself and figure it out? That's kind of the way that I try to live my life. And so, I have some baby must-haves. And if you haven't seen my current favorites video, go watch that, because I kind of included, like, a mommy favorites, like, segment in that video. So make sure that you go watch that after this video. How long have you been married? Tyler and I have been married a year and a half this week, which is just crazy because I feel like we just got married yesterday. This is the bronzer that I just used. It's just the True Matte bronzer powder, or it's actually not even a bronzer. It's just a regular powder, but I don't like my bronzer to be shimmery. So this is just in the color neutral. What's the hardest part of marriage? I think, Tyler and I have a pretty, awesome marriage because we get along for the most part. We hardly ever argue. The hardest part, I think, is just making sure that your finances are constantly in check, no matter the time of day, time of night. And just always trying to grow and get better at your finances. That's the hardest thing for me, I feel like. What makes you feel at peace? That kind of goes hand in hand with my guilty pleasure. I feel like the thing that makes me feel most at peace is just having a clean home and my family at home and my to-do list done and no notifications. It sounds silly, but I also love a good bath. So yeah, I love just a relaxing bath as well. How do you always keep such a positive attitude about everything, and how do you stay energized? Try to stay energized just by getting a good night of sleep, and then I use what's called energy fizz sticks, and those I showed in my current favorites video. So if you haven't seen that, make sure that you go and watch that after, like I've said 1,000 times. But I use those a lot of times to stay energized. I like to try and get a workout in if I can. How do I keep a positive attitude? I just feel like you have so much control of your own mind and the Lord has control over your life. So what is there really to worry about? And if you can't get in control of your own mind, you need to read books. You need to go see a therapist. You need to do whatever you can to get in control of your own mind. That was the best thing I ever did for myself. And I just know that everything happens for a reason and life will always go on. And one day I will get to spend forever and eternity. And that is just something that brings me joy, knowing that, like, I know that one day there will be no more pain, no more suffering, that kind of thing. So that's kind of, sounds cliche again, but that's just how I think. Your biggest pet peeve. My number one biggest pet peeve is whenever I get done cleaning something and someone messes it up and doesn't clean it back how I had it. Number one. And number two is whenever someone doesn't change the freaking toilet paper, and my mom never does it, and I still have to change her toilet paper whenever I go to her house. So mom, if you're watching, start changing your darn toilet paper. If you could move to any state, which one would it be? Honestly, I think that I would move to Florida just because I love the sunshine. I'm familiar with the state and Tyler's parents are there. And so that would give me a lot more security because I rely on my family a lot, if you didn't already know that. How do you stay so positive and upbeat in troubled times? You go, girl. Thank you guys so much for recognizing that I'm a positive person and that I just kind of like go with the punches. It's just something that I learned in that, like, growing up, no hate to my parents, I love them so much, but growing up with divorced parents, I feel like that's just something that you kind of gain is just either a very positive attitude or you gain a very negative attitude. And so I just realized through time that why would I live my life with a negative attitude with all the things that are going on? I'm just gonna know that this is gonna make me a just better person. It's gonna make me a stronger person and all of those kinds of things. So that is just, yeah. Did you have a hard labor? No, I feel like I had a really easy labor and I would give birth 10 times over. If you haven't seen my labor story, I do have that up on my channel. So I can link that for you guys as well. How do you keep up with a messy house? I struggle every day. Honestly, I make myself clean up after myself, after the baby, and after Tyler every single day, no matter what I've got going on, and no matter what, I clean up after us. I make a huge pile of stuff that I have to get done, and I cannot stand to have a dirty home. So that is more or less why. Is I just can't stand a dirty home, but I feel like having a routine. So like Mondays, I mop. Tuesdays, I make sure that the dishes are loaded and reloaded and ready to be ran, and Tyler runs the dishes whenever he gets home. This is just like a Kenra blow dry spray. It's a heat protectant. I don't think that you're really supposed to put it on your hair dry, but whatever. We all do stuff that we probably shouldn't do, so it's fine. And it smells so good. But, oh, and the lipstick that I just used, I talked about this on my Instagram, so if you don't follow me on Instagram, go do that. But this is just a Wet n Wild lipstick. It's 914C Mochalicious, and I love this color. But I just have like a to-do list of every single day of things that I want to accomplish, and I don't clean my whole entire house most of the time all at one time. Like, I will do one thing at a time. One day I will have a few things on my list of stuff that I need to do, and that is how I go about it, so that then I don't overwhelm myself. I make my bed every single morning whenever I wake up, any dirty clothes that haven't gotten into the hamper, they go into the dirty clothes. And if you just stay on top of loading your dishes right after you get done eating, then that helps too. And I just try to stay on top of the dishes and stay on top of all the cleaning, because whenever you let it all pile up, it just gets overwhelming and then you don't even know where to start with cleaning it, you know? I have certain times throughout the day whenever Carson is playing and he's having like individual play time, or whenever Carson has his lunch, I will clean up the kitchen or whatever. I also don't have a super huge home, so that helps, I feel like, too. That is the biggest thing for me, is my apartment is so small, so keeping it cleaned up is huge. I vacuum once a day and I mop every other day. How did you start working at the Dry Bar and do you love it? I started working at the Dry Bar because at the end of cosmetology school, I was like, what the heck am I gonna do? I'm 7 months pregnant, I need a job, but I don't wanna color hair, I don't wanna cut hair, because I hated coloring hair and I just didn't understand formulas of that and that kind of thing. Some people just don't. And so I was looking, telling my friends, I don't know what I'm gonna do, I hate color, I hate cuts, all that. And so I started looking around for places that I could be like a receptionist. Well, whenever I told my friends that I didn't wanna do colors or cuts, one of my friends, Cassidy, she actually does my hair now, she told me to look into the Dry Bar. So I reached out to another girl that I knew, her name is Haley, and she's one of my really good friends now, love her. And she told me her manager's phone number for the Dry Bar, and that was basically, the rest was history. I love the Dry Bar, I make good money, there's no booth rent, there's no product fees. And like I said, everyone is just so sweet and so awesome, and it's just the best job I could have ever landed. And I love all my coworkers and my boss and the owner, they're all amazing. Please talk about the pain level before, during, and after pregnancy. So like I said, if you haven't seen my labor and delivery story, I'll have that linked for you guys, but go watch that too, because I don't really remember what all I said in there, but I know that I said a lot of helpful stuff. Make sure that you eat right before you go into the hospital, because you can't eat. And I'm pretty sure that I counted last night and I labored for like 19 hours and then I pushed for less than 30 minutes, or roughly 30 minutes, but so I couldn't eat for 19 hours. So the pain was awful, I think more or less because I hadn't eaten. But it's really not like unbearable. So like you can totally do it. It's not the worst pain in the world, and it brings you the greatest gift ever. Like I'm dead serious. I would give birth 17,000 times over just to have a baby. Like Carson is the greatest thing in the entire world. So, and then while I was pushing, honestly pushing, I will tell you right now, I was a champ. I pushed that baby out so fast. You know your body, you know how fast you can push out, you know all of those things. They're not joking whenever they say like motherly instincts kicks in. They are dead serious about that. I pushed 8 times in a row, twice, and the baby was out, I'm pretty sure is how many times I had to do it. And yeah, it was so easy, and he came right out, and he was perfect, and he was just a little angel, and he still is. And then after pregnancy, I feel like the worst part of after pregnancy, I wasn't even really that sore. I had had gallbladder surgery and a heart surgery all within 6 months of each other, so I feel like I had an unfair advantage whenever it comes to like the feeling of stomach pain and like feeling like you got hit by a bus. Honestly, my gallbladder surgery was worse than that. After the worst part is just going pee and showering and cleaning yourself. That is just, it's not really fun, but life goes on and you just created life, so how can you even complain? Okay, I think that this is the last question. Do you still get to do the fun things like going out with friends? How often do you and Ty get to have a date night? Tyler and I have had 2 date nights since we had Carson. And that's basically just because we like taking Carson everywhere. We don't really love to rely on help. I've had so much help this past week, and it has been honestly kind of like life-changing for me. And I cannot thank all of our family enough for just all of the help that they've lended us this week. But I also have just been so busy, but Tyler and I barely ever get date nights, but we also just love hanging out with our friends. Like, I would rather go and hang out with our friends with Tyler than I would go on a date 9 times out of 10, because we just have so much fun hanging out with our friends. We have a very like solid core group of friends. I think that there's like about 10 of us. And if you follow me on Instagram, once again, you've seen pictures of us all together. We've gone to Florida together. We are about to go to Tennessee together in October to celebrate a couple of our friends' birthdays. And they are just the sweetest. They love Karsten. They help with Karsten and they want him involved in everything. And they understand whenever he has a bedtime and it's time for me to go to sleep. And they just are, our friends are literally angels. Like, if you're watching this, guys, I love you so much. I could literally cry. Like, it's gonna make me cry just thinking about how much I love you guys. Dead serious. Tyler and I could not have been blessed with better friends. Our friends are seriously angels. And one of our friends, she has a little boy and he is 2 and he's so sweet, and him and Karsten are going to be best friends. And yeah, we just really scored having friends that care about our kid and that just understand that we are parents, but we're still young and we're still down to have fun, but we have to respect our kid, and we just have to respect the understanding of having a kid. Okay, so that is all the questions. I'm gonna finish curling this piece of my hair. I'm gonna show you a couple close-ups of my makeup, and then I'm gonna show you my outfit. I love me a good beachy wave. This curling iron, what even is this called? The Babyliss Pro, I'm pretty sure it's the 1-inch. Greatest curling iron ever. Oh my gosh, I just realized I never did my mascara. What am I doing? The greatest thing ever. What is my brain right now? I'm just using a mascara from Mary Kay. I love Mary Kay's mascara. Silly me, silly me. My current favorite outfit, I'm just wearing a cropped crew neck from Walmart. It's just a Gildan brand. And then these cute shorts from Old Navy. I've been loving Old Navy track shorts. And then I'm also wearing these cute Birkenstocks from Buckle. So they're not really Birkenstocks, but they're basically Birks. And they're just so stinking cute. I love them. But anyway, thank you guys so, so much for watching this video. I hope that you learned a ton about me. Make sure that you let me know down in the comments something that you either learned about me or something that I probably don't know about you. I love getting to know you guys. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up. Make sure you comment, like I said, and subscribe for more videos. See ya!